Request you to formally welcome our beloved and learned and a very scholarly distinguished speaker, Professor Rakesh Godwani.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity once again. In fact, I had two devices today working. I was on the standby with the second one, so I could manage the second one. And thankfully to our previous speaker who gave us this motivation that we must be ready with our equipments. So I tried to grab it, and this is what was the takeaway for me for today's session. And since the speaker is ready, Dr. Rakesh Godwani, as I have been told, is a wonderful, miraculous speaker. So he is the founder of School of Meaningful Experiences, an online edtech startup in Bangalore. He has also taught communication at IIM Bangalore and IIM Udaipur. Dr. Godwani coaches promising startups and senior managers in the industry, gives seminars and talks in corporate events and colleges, reads a story to his kids every night before they sleep, bicycles, does yoga, writes, earns a fraction of what he used to, but lives a million times better. Sir's research and teaching interests focus on how a charismatic leader builds a persuasive message to impact audiences. His fourth book, titled Public Speaking Kaleidoscope, was released by Business Expert Press USA in May 2017. His earlier book, What to Say and When to Shut Up, was published by Penguin Random House in November 2014 and translated in Marathi in 2017. Rakesh recently launched his online course on edX and IIMBX called Effective Business Communication, designed for learners around the world. Besides this, Dr. Godwani also has his own podcast called Plunge, which is available on Spotify, Google, Apple Podcast apps, or on his website. Amazing, sir. Prior to his plunge into teaching and writing, Dr. Godwani worked with companies like Wipro, Intel, and Qualcomm in various capacities ranging from engineering to business development. He also volunteers with Vishwas Society for Mental Health, an organization that offers free confidential counseling. MOOCs on soft skills and communications are highly sought after on social. We may not be able to express what we want to tell about sir, but what will happen and what will matter is what sir is going to give us in this power-packed session of 2 hours. And let us go ahead and look into what sir has in offering for us, because sir, we have been having a wonderful day since morning and we love to listen to you, sir. I have heard so much for you, sir. Welcome to you, sir.
Thank you very much, Dr. Divya and Dr. Ashish. It is such an honor that all of you invited me and are eagerly waiting to listen to me. I find this so endearing, and I'm so grateful because nobody listens to me at home. And it's such a joy to have an audience to listen to. So I am also very thrilled that all of you are associated with a center of life skills. I'm so happy to hear that. If there is one big problem our education has done, that is to give life skills a complete ignorance. And I'm so proud that all of you are doing this. May your departments grow and may you all impact lives. I think we have damaged an entire generation with a lot of focus on subjects which are important, but probably are not useful after a point. And this is where human life, human connection, understanding the self, understanding others, communication are subjects which should be given a lot more importance. But unfortunately, there is a history to this. And I can tell you with my own experiences, when I signed up for my PhD program, and I'm a very, let me step back. All the words you said are very nice, very beautiful. Thank you very much. But I am one of the most mediocre, probably in the lowest quartile when it comes to measuring ranks, kind of a student. I always had very bad marks. I was always disconnected with the system of exams and education. But I had to go through it because that's the only way our country works. And it probably, it won't change in the near future. So I signed up for a PhD program in Cardiff Metropolitan only because of two reasons. One, it allowed me to do PhD on my terms. And I always wanted to work, study, write at the same time. All institutions said that no, you have to do full time. And I would question then that what's the logic behind full time? I mean, sometimes I use these Hindi words, which I'll also use. कि सर फुल टाइम में क्या तीर उखाड़ लोगे आप? एंड पार्ट टाइम में ऐसा क्या प्रॉब्लम है कि नहीं रिगर एंड आई समटाइम्स फाइंड दीज वर्ड्स वेरी हिलेरियस कि इफ यू टेक अ पर्सन और उसको आप चेन से बांध के कुर्सी पे बिठाओ दैट इज कॉल्ड रिगर एंड इफ दिस पर्सन सेज कि सर मैं नहीं बैठना चाहता हूँ मैं काम करूंगा पढ़ाई करूंगा पढ़ाऊंगा दैट इज कॉल्ड डिस्ट्रैक्शन एंड मुझे कभी कभार हमारे एकेडमिशियंस की थॉट प्रोसेस पे रोना आता है कि यार वी आर इन द बिजनेस ऑफ चेंजिंग लाइव्स इफ वी डोंट चेंज आर सेल्व्स समथिंग हैज गॉन रॉन्ग एंड दैट इज व्हाट आई वांट टू टॉक टू यू अबाउट कि कम्युनिकेशन इज नॉट जस्ट इंग्लिश इट इज अ सब्जेक्ट दैट हैज द पावर ऑफ ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग लाइव्स And you can transform lives only when you transform yourselves. हमारे बच्चे हमारे स्टूडेंट्स हंसते हैं हम लोगों पर कि सर आपने तो कभी कोई बुक लिखी नहीं आपने तो कभी कोई स्पीच दी नहीं पढ़ा रहे हो कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स हमको राइट एंड दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम विद अकेडमिया टुडे दैट द चाइल्ड और द लर्नर वॉन्ट्स टू बी इंस्पायर्ड बाय अस बट लुक्स एट अस एंड इज वेरी अनइंस्पायर्ड एंड All of you, as teachers who are torch bearers of the society, must improve your communication skills. I'm not saying you are bad at it. I'm saying the time has come to transform our understanding on this subject. This subject is not English. This subject is human connection. It can connect only with a smile, certain words, certain ideas, the way we interact with each other. उसमें हिंदी मलयालम इंग्लिश जो चलेगा चलाएंगे एंड इट्स टाइम फॉर अस टू ब्रिंग दिस सेंटर ऑफ लाइफ साइंसेज नॉट जस्ट एज अ सेंटर बट अ डिपार्टमेंट इन द यूनिवर्सिटी हमारी यूनिवर्सिटीज में बहुत प्रॉब्लम्स हैं वन ऑफ देम इज दैट वी डू नॉट गिव अ डिपार्टमेंट स्टेटस टू दीज टॉपिक्स बिकॉज दे फील कि नहीं, इकोनॉमिक स्ट्रेटजी डिपार्टमेंट स्टेटस Life skills and all these department of theater, drama, hobbies. And I think that should change. This subject deserves attention. There is a lot of academic research that happens around the world. I think in India, we have kind of lost ourselves for a variety of reasons, but I think we are beginning to understand why it's important, which is very good. This webinar and FTP organized by all of you is a shining example of that. And what I want to submit to all of you is a simple thought process on communication and take you on a journey with me through some incidences, stories, episodes. And I'd like you to chat with me. There's a chat window. I'm right now in Bangalore, in the south of Bangalore. So I'd like to hear from you on the chat while I'm speaking. Tell me which cities you're from so that I have a perspective. और अगर आप अपना वीडियो ऑन करेंगे तो मुझे बड़ी खुशी होगी अनलेस देयर इज अ टेक्निकल प्रॉब्लम इट साउंड्स लाइक कि मैं अपने आप से ही बात कर रहा हूँ सो प्लीज स्विच ऑन योर वीडियोस इफ यू कैन आई लव टू सी लवली फेसेस अरे वाह क्या बढ़िया बढ़िया चेहरे हैं आप लोगों के वाह लुक एट दिस सी हाउ स्माइल्स कम राइट इससे पहले हम लोग सब खड़ूस की तरह बैठे हुए थे अब थोड़ा स्माइल आ गया एंड दिस इज कम्युनिकेशन एंड दिस इज वॉट वी शुड डू और रोहतक दिल्ली हरिद्वार चेन्नई मुंबई वापी अम्बाला अरे वाह दिस इज पावर ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी चेगुड़ी बपटाला आंध्र प्रदेश वेरी नाइस रोहतक वेरी गुड अहमदनगर आई एम सो हैप्पी मजा आ गया मतलब आज तो फुल मॉर्निंग इज वर्थ इट सो वी हैव अबाउट 2 आवर्स बट आई डोंट वॉन्ट इट टू बी अ मोनोलॉग वी विल टॉक टू ईच अदर एज मच एज वी कैन एंड कीप दोज चैट्स कमिंग मैं पढ़ भी रहा हूँ गुरुग्राम सोनीपत वेरी गुड विशाखापट्टनम आई थिंक वन ऑफ द बेस्ट थिंग्स दैट हैज हैपेंड टू एजुकेशन आई एम सॉरी टू से दिस इन अ नेगेटिव वे आई एम वेरी डीपली सैडन्ड बाय व्हाट दिस हैज डन टू आर हेल्थ एंड इकोनॉमी But COVID-19 was the best kick education could get. Agar wo nahi hota, to kabhi kuch change nahi hone wala tha. And I'm so happy ki COVID-19 has shattered all the, big walls of education ki bhaiya ab online bhi ho sakta hai. And wake up, smell the coffee. और ये जो आप राज करते थे यूनिवर्सिटीज में बैठ के लाइन लगती थी स्टूडेंट्स की वो सब चले जाएंगे एंड यू हैव टू आस्क योरसेल्फ व्हाट इज इट दैट यू आर डूइंग विथ योर ओन करियर. सो ऑन दैट नोट आई थिंक वी शुड नॉट फॉरगेट दैट इट्स एन अपॉर्चुनिटी. लेट्स मेक द बेस्ट यूज ऑफ इट. लेट्स नॉट गो बैक टू आर ओल्ड सिस्टम्स एंड लेट्स ब्रिंग दीज सब्जेक्ट्स इनटू मॉडर्न रियलिटी. सो आई वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट माई ओन PhD प्रोग्राम एंड आई टेल यू वाई आई डू कम्युनिकेशन. 1996 जब मैं थर्ड ईयर कॉलेज में था, फाइनल ईयर में जस्ट एंटर होने वाला था, माय मार्क्स वर वेरी बैड. कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग इन वन ऑफ अ गुड कॉलेजेस ऑफ इंडिया. देयर इज अ स्टोरी ऑफ हाउ आई वेंट टू दैट कॉलेज व्हिच आई टेल यू लेटर. कभी भगवान ने चाहा तो वापस मिलेंगे. एंड 1996 में पहली बार 1993 में आई लेफ्ट माय होम प्रोटेक्टेड एनवायरमेंट ऑफ अ lower middle class family. I come from Jodhpur and from a family of academics, teachers, doctors. And so I came to South and 3 saal bahut masti mari. I think that's when I realized ki are, there are so many things in life except books. And I made friendships, I traveled, I saw people, I ate their food, I connected with them. I started reading about the world through magazines जो हमारे कॉलेज में आती थी and पढ़ाई तो कभी करी नहीं and 62% स्कोर था मेरा and टॉपर ऑफ द क्लास वॉज 84% and जॉब के तो लाले पड़े हुए थे कि यार अब जॉब के लिए तो मार्क्स चाहिए and but by some quirk of fate, भगवान is there, I got an opportunity to enter Wipro. And Wipro वालों ने मुझे मुंह पे बोला कि यार यू आर द वर्स्ट इंजीनियर वी हैव सीन इन आवर लाइफ. तेरे से कोडिंग वोडिंग होगी नहीं पर तू बात अच्छी करता है एंड वी नीड पीपल लाइक यू बिकॉज हमारे कंपनी में वी नीड पीपल हु टॉक कनेक्ट. एंड ऐसा नहीं है कि मैं बस बात करके ही काम करता था. आई कुड लर्न कंप्यूटर्स. मुझे कभी इंस्पिरेशन नहीं मिली तो आई नेवर लर्नड. सो दे सेड वील ट्रेन यू एंड द डायलॉग ही सेड विच आई शुड टेल यू. बोलता है मेरे को कि राकेश तेरे को हम 1 महीने में इंजीनियर बना देंगे. एंड उस दिन मैंने अपना मैंने अपने आप को चमाट मारा कि यार 4 साल बर्बाद कर दिए. एंड दिस गाय सेज कि मैं 1 महीने में तेरे को इंजीनियर बना दूंगा. एंड दिस इज वेयर माई लाइफ चेंज कि यार आई गॉट माई जॉब नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ माई कंप्यूटर्स बट बिकॉज ऑफ माई एबिलिटी टू कनेक्ट. तो आई स्टार्टेड एंजॉइंग दिस मोर and that gave me the confidence. मैं फिर विप्रो आया. विप्रो में अगेन आई सॉ सारे इंजीनियर्स बात नहीं करेंगे, सब लोग कोडिंग करेंगे एंड द पीपल वुड रिगार्ड ईच अदर ऑन कोड एंड आई वॉज अ मिसफिट एंड आई नेवर फिटेड दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो आई फाउंड माई स्पेस एंड somehow survived and got promoted. Again, the feedback was, you are a person who can handle interactions very well. You are not a bad engineer. And then I went to Intel. And that's when somebody came to me and said that, sir, I'm not confident. Mujhe bahut dar lagta hai logon ke samne. Can you help me? And I said, that's very easy. And I started teaching this person on the weekends. 10 log aur aa gaye. And then I slowly started doing workshops on communication. And I found it amazingly joyful. I mean, this is that feeling that I waited for every weekend. So Monday to Friday, I was in the corporate. Bahut badhiya tankha, amazing money. But Saturday, Sunday was the best part of my time. And not because of weekends, it's because of teaching. And this continued till 2004. And I had 2 jobs by 2004. And Monday to Friday, I was a very successful corporate manager. I think by 2004, I had finished my MBA program from IIM Bangalore. Part-time MBA program, मैं ज़्यादा intelligent नहीं हूँ, ये cat vet मेरे को तो समझ में भी नहीं आता है. मैं वो 3 idiots का एक dialogue है कि पढ़ने के लिए uniform चाहिए. I'm that kind of a guy. तो मैंने IIM बैंगलोर को देखा, स्टडी किया, तो एक गेट है वहां पे लंबी लाइन लगी हुई है, पीछे जाओ तो एक छोटा गेट है, वहां पे छोटी सी लाइन है। मैंने कहा हाँ, इस लाइन में मैं खड़ा हो सकता हूँ, एंड दैट इज द पार्ट टाइम MBA प्रोग्राम। एंड आई नेवर हैड एनी ड्रीम कि मैं बैंकर बनूंगा। मेरे को तो आई वॉज वेरी हैप्पी विद कंप्यूटर्स एंड माई लिटिल लाइफ, मेरे को तो टीचिंग भी अच्छी लगती थी। सो आई फाउंड दैट प्रोग्राम एंड इट गेव मी वॉट आई वॉन्टेड, इट गेव मी एन इनसाइट इन टू बिजनेस। माई करियर टुक ऑफ एंड आई वॉज अ वेरी सीनियर गाय एट इंटेल, एंड एवरीबडी एट इंटेल ऑल्सो सेड कि यार यू मे नॉट हैव द राइट स्किल्स टू मेक अ चिप एंड अ प्रोडक्ट, बट यू आर वेरी गुड इन कनेक्टिंग विद पीपल, यू कैन हैंडल थिंग्स, तू लड़ाई भी सॉल्व कर सकता है। सो आई स्टार्टेड लर्निंग लीडरशिप स्किल्स विच आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड लाइफ स्किल्स, एंड कम्युनिकेशन इज द हार्ट ऑफ इट। एंड बाई 2004 आई मेड दिस रोमांटिक डिसीजन कि यार टीचिंग इज माई फर्स्ट लव एंड आई एम नॉट फिटिंग द कॉर्पोरेट, बट दैट्स द टाइम आई हैड आर आई एंड माई वाइफ हैड आर चाइल्ड, कियान वॉज अबाउट 3 years ओल्ड आई थिंक, समहाउ माई नेम इज हिज नेम बिकॉज ही वॉज यूजिंग माई कंप्यूटर, आई शुड फाइंड अ वे टू चेंज दैट। सो ही वॉज बॉर्न एंड बिल्स हैव टू बी पेड एंड लाइफ इज नॉट ईजी इन टीचिंग। सो आई चिकन आउट एंड आई सेड कि नहीं, लेट्स बिकम अ बेटर मैनेजर। सो बाई 2007 आई वॉज अ वेरी गुड मैनेजर इन क्वालकॉम, बट दिस बग ऑफ टीचिंग वॉज वेरी वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग, एंड आई सेड दिस इज इट, आई कांट हैंडल टू जॉब्स, समथिंग हैज टू गो। टीचिंग में पैसा नहीं है, बट आई समहाउ मेड अ वेरी टफ डिसीजन ऑफ माई लाइफ ऑफ किलिंग माई एंटायर कॉर्पोरेट पाथ विच वॉज वेरी हैवीली पेड। इन 2007 आई वॉज वन ऑफ द हाइएस्ट पेड पीपल इन द कॉर्पोरेट वर्ल्ड एंड वर्किंग इन द बेस्ट कंपनी क्वालकॉम, वर्किंग विद द बेस्ट पीपल, बिजनेस क्लास ट्रेवल करता था मैं। बट अगेन माई हार्ट वॉज इन टीचिंग, सो सैटरडे संडे व्हेन आई यूज टू टीच आई यूज टू फील सो हैप्पी। इन फैक्ट आई स्टिल रिमेम्बर फेब्रुअरी ऑफ 2008, मैं बहुत थका हुआ था, आई वॉज बर्न आउट बिकॉज आई वॉज ऑल्सो अ गुड मैनेजर एंड अबाउट टू बिकम अ डायरेक्टर इन क्वालकॉम। तो मैंने 2008 में आई वॉज टोटली लॉस्ट कन्फ्यूज, ट्रेवलिंग अराउंड 18-19 days a month, आई हैड ऑल द मनी द बैंक आई कुड वॉन्ट, बट आई वॉज नॉट हैप्पी। सो एक दिन मैंने ऑफिस फोन किया बॉम्बे में कि यार मैं ऑफिस नहीं आ रहा, एंड आई सैट डाउन एट बैंड स्टैंड। इफ यू आर फेमिलियर विद बॉम्बे, बॉम्बे हैज द बीच टूवर्ड्स द साउथ साइड, एंड बैंड स्टैंड इज लाइक द टिप ऑफ बॉम्बे एंड मोर फेमसली नोन बिकॉज मेनी फिल्म स्टार्स लिव देयर, शाहरुख खान का घर इज राइट देयर, एंड आई यूज टू लिव नियर बाय बिकॉज आई वॉज क्वाइट रिच वेन इट कम्स टू कॉर्पोरेट स्टैंडर्ड्स, एंड आई कुड अफोर्ड अ हाउस, रेंटल हाउस इन दैट प्लेस। इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू स्टे देयर, दैट प्लेस इज कॉल्ड माउंट मेरी, और वहाँ पे सब फिल्म स्टार और बड़े बड़े लोगों के घर हैं। आई लिव्ड देयर एंड आई एम ग्रेटफुल टू गॉड आई हैड अ चांस, बट मैं बहुत लॉस्ट था। सो आई केम डाउन टू बैंड स्टैंड एंड देयर अ चाय वाली दुकान टपरी, सो आई वेंट एंड सैट देयर एंड आई सेड टू दिस गाय कि तू चाय लेके आ बिकॉज आई टुडे आई एम नॉट गोइंग एनीवेयर एंड आई हैव टू रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन माई लाइफ, एंड आई ड्रू अ सिंपल ग्राफ ऑफ माई लाइफ। एंड चाय पीते पीते ओशन की वेव्स को देखते देखते आई ड्रू एक्स एंड वाई एक्सेस। ऑन द वाई एक्सेस आई रोट मनी एंड हैप्पीनेस, एंड ऑन द एक्स एक्सेस आई रोट मंडे ट्यूजडे वेडनेसडे थर्सडे फ्राइडे सैटरडे संडे, एंड समबडी सेज दे वर्क एट ताज लैंड्स एंड, सो यू नो एग्जैक्टली वॉट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट, एंड यू कैन पिक्चर दिस टपरी विच इज राइट इन फ्रंट ऑफ ताज लैंड्स एंड, इट स्टिल इज देयर। सो आई वॉज सिटिंग देयर एंड आई प्लॉटेड दिस ग्राफ, मंडे टू फ्राइडे माई मनी वॉज वेरी हाई, आई वॉज वेरी हाईली पेड, आई कुड बाय एनीथिंग आई वॉन्ट, आई मीन ऑनेस्टली इफ आई वॉन्टेड अ न्यू कार आई कुड जस्ट वॉक इन टू द शोरूम एंड बाय दैट कार, आई हैड सो मच मनी, बट आई वॉज सो अनहैप्पी, सो माई हैप्पीनेस क्वोशेंट वॉज नेगेटिव। एंड ऑन सैटरडे संडे आई वॉज अ टीचर एंड मनी वॉज जीरो, बट हैप्पीनेस वॉज सो हाई दैट आई कुड नॉट प्लॉट इट ऑन दैट पीस ऑफ पेपर, एंड दैट्स द डे आई न्यू कि आई एम इन द रॉन्ग इंडस्ट्री एंड आई हैव टू मेक अ चॉइस। आई वॉज 30 years ओल्ड विद अ वेरी लोन काइंड ऑफ अ प्रॉब्लम ऑन माई शोल्डर्स बट लॉट ऑफ मनी, एंड आई सेड कि बॉस ये तो नहीं होने वाला, आई विल लीव द कॉर्पोरेट वर्ल्ड एंड आई विल फिगर आउट अ वे टू फाइंड मनी इन टीचिंग। सो आई रिजाइंड इन मे 2008, एग्जैक्टली 13 years ago, One of you is, I think there is a noise coming from your speaker, so if you can mute yourself, thank you very much. So I resigned in 2008 and started my journey.
Sir, I'll request you to kindly unmute yourself.
Got it. Yes. So in 2008, May, 30th May, I resigned, and we are on 7th June, 8th June today. So yeah, 13 years ago, I resigned and started my journey as a full-time teacher on hire. So jahan classroom milti thi, main pahunch jata tha. And I have taught in more than, I think, 40, 50 colleges, more than 60, 70 schools. Sometimes there was an apartment complex, wahan pe maine jaake padhai karwai. And I just love their interaction. And my belief is the same, ki padhane ke liye building nahi chahiye. Padhane ke liye padhne wala chahiye. So if you get your student and you have a Bodhi tree, that is the school. And Sandipni was created because of that. So these principles of communication and, sorry, principles of education were in me. So I left, then I did my PhD program. Mere ek colleague hain, IIM Bangalore mein, Sajjan, very nice teacher of mine, because main padha hoon wahan pe, and I started working at IIM Bangalore. I became the head of alumni. And then I started teaching as an adjunct professor there. I still offer an elective at IIM Bangalore and teach one course at IIM Udaipur. So I have very fond memories of my teachers who became my friends. They became my mentors. One of them said, ki Rakesh, tu PhD kar raha hai, very good. Kaun se subject mein kar raha hai? I looked at him and said, sir, communication. His face fell. Bolta hai, communication mein paisa nahi hai. You should switch to economics. I said, sir, main aise sochta hi nahi hu. I can't think like this. And communication mujhe achha lagta hai. He said, ki Rakesh, koi future nahi hai. There is no journal jisme tu publish karega India mein. There is no department of communication in any IIMs and IITs and all these big colleges. You are lost. I said, sir, I have no intention to join any of these departments. I want to first study communication. Phir dekhenge. And I really want to understand how communication can change life. So I want to do a research on that. And I was fascinated by TED Talks. Ki sir, ye TED Talks are so inspiring and I want to study them. Ki ye log kya janam se aise hain ya they can be developed and created. That became my PhD topic. So I spent 6 years of struggling PhD topic. By the way, on the Viva of my PhD final day, I failed. I mean, you could guess it by ki main itna hi-fi student nahi hu. Main fail ho gaya. Luckily, so there are some levels of PhD. I was expecting a minor submission. They gave me a major, which is very insulting. Matlab, 5 chapter mein se 2 chapter wapis likho. What rubbish is this? I was so heartbroken. I still remember that day, 22 March 2017. I don't know why they broke my heart. I thought I deserved a PhD, but I think that morning, ye teen jo the na guides, कुछ हो गया होगा, घर पे लड़ाई हो गई होगी, बीवी ने मार दिया होगा, दे सेट कि आज इसको सबक सिखाएंगे. सो आई बिकेम द गिनी पिग. आई वाज टोल्ड कि यार यू विल सेल थ्रू. माय गाइड सेट कि तेरा हो जाना चाहिए, ऐसा कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. बट समथिंग वेंट रॉन्ग. आई डोंट नो व्हाट वेंट रॉन्ग एंड दीज 3 पीपल फेल्ड मी. आई क्राइड अ लॉट, आई मस्ट कन्फेस. बहुत रोया मैं उस दिन. आई मीन दिस वॉज माई ड्रीम शैटर डे. एंड दैट्स द डे I'm so happy मुझे वो failure मिला, because that's the day I thought about our education system very differently. कि यार इतने पापड़ बेलने के बाद भी ये तीन लोग खुश नहीं है. Imagine our students, the hell we are making them go through. So I started thinking differently. Then I said कि मैं किसी institution के साथ connect ही नहीं करूँगा. I'll create my own. My dream of starting my venture started. मेरे पास एक फिक्स डिपॉजिट थी, वो मैंने ब्रेक करके स्कूल ऑफ मीनिंगफुल एक्सपीरियंसेस बनाया. एंड वी टीच ओनली कम्युनिकेशन. हमारे पास फोन कॉल आते हैं कि आप AI ML पढ़ाओगे क्या, उसमें बहुत पैसा है. एंड आई एम लाइक AI ML मेरे को समझ में ही नहीं आता. आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड. आई कैन टीच यू कम्युनिकेशन ऑन AI ML, बट नॉट नथिंग मोर देन दैट. So School of Meaningful Experiences is an organization that focuses on 6 C's, and now I'll connect it to the topic charismatic leadership, which is firmly the research area that all of us as human beings of 21st century have to find a way to survive, handle jobs, deal with this complex machine called life. And in this complex machine called life, you need a lot more than science, math, and history, civics, geography. I think you need 6 C's. The first is you need to have confidence. And this is my first problem with our education system. Ki education system ke bahar nikalne ke baad, ek bachcha itna dara hua nikalta hai. If you think about it, it's a very bizarre observation. If you look at a very uneducated human being, sometimes unko dar nahi lagta. They are living life nicely. और हमारे जो टॉपर्स को देखिए आप, वो बाहर निकलते हैं कॉलेज से डरे हुए निकलते हैं, बिकॉज दे आर सो एंशियस अबाउट देयर फ्यूचर. एंड द प्रॉब्लम इज उनका कॉन्फिडेंस बहुत लो होता है, एंड द कॉन्फिडेंस इज शैटर्ड बिकॉज ऑफ एग्जाम्स, द जजमेंट वी गिव देम. दे आर गुड इन सब्जेक्ट ए, बट इन सब्जेक्ट बी मार्क्स अच्छे नहीं आते हैं, तो दे फील दे आर नॉट गुड इनफ. सो इट्स अ सीरियस प्रॉब्लम. सो आई स्टार्टेड टू रिसर्च ऑन इट, एंड वी हैव फाउंड अ सॉल्यूशन टू इम्प्रूव कॉन्फिडेंस. कॉन्फिडेंस अच्छा होगा तो कम्युनिकेशन भी अच्छा होगा, एंड वी क्रैक्ड अ साइंस फॉर दैट. आई हैव रिटन टू बुक्स ऑन इट एंड आई विल टॉक अबाउट इट एज वेल. द थर्ड इज क्यूरियोसिटी. अगर इफ अ लर्नर एंड अ मैनेजर एंड टीचर्स आर नॉट क्यूरियस, यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू कम्युनिकेट वेरी वेल, बिकॉज क्यूरियोसिटी इज द फ्यूल फॉर कम्युनिकेशन. कम्युनिकेशन इज अ वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स कोग्निटिव प्रोसेस. यू टेक समथिंग फ्रॉम योर ब्रेन विच इज इंफॉर्मेशन, translate it to some words and language, apply some delivery techniques and throw it out. But that process of getting something from your brain is very critical. And aajkal tumhare brain mein WhatsApp ke alawa kuch hai hi nahi. So what do you speak? And that's where curiosity comes in. And the reading and research habits of students is very, very dull. That's why they are not able to articulate. So when somebody comes to me, this is a classic example. We work with teenagers, pre-teenagers, all the way to CEOs and middle managers. When somebody comes and says, ki sir, mere ko padhna achha nahi lagta, aap kuch bhi kara lo, I say ki I can't help you. I think you're intellectually dead. And if you can't be curious and if you can't read, I can't teach you to become a better communicator. Right? It's like saying, ki sir, humko moon pe jana hai, पेट्रोल मत डालवाना. What kind of a science is this? Without petrol, how will the rocket go up? So curiosity is the fuel for going up, and you have to invest. So that's third C. The fourth is creativity. The mind has to really think various dimensions in a creative, out of the box thinking. It can be called innovation also. The same problem can be thought in different ways. That's creativity. And the fifth one is collaboration. You will not survive alone in this world. You have to connect with people, collaborate with them. This is where our society is going through a lot of problem, which is social anxiety. So I talk about that. Many people are very happy doing their work in isolation. A PhD program is the best example. What is a PhD program? Isolate yourself, kisi se baat mat karo. And for 5-6 years, kitabon se hi baat karo. But the problem is that when you finish the PhD program, you need to talk to people. And that's where all our scientists are very difficult when it comes to collaboration. And the same thing happens with students. Ki ratta maar ke marks to sab le aayenge. Collaboration kaun karega? And that's where they come to me. Ki sir, I don't like talking to people. I'm very introverted. And I'm like, boss, being introverted doesn't mean you can't speak. So don't get your definitions from Google. There is a science behind all of that. Ye WhatsApp or Google padhna chodo and start learning the art of collaboration. Ki jaake kaam karna yaar. So collaborate. And our teachers are the worst in collaboration. In fact, the joke is a person who cannot speak with anyone, PhD kar jaake. And I find it bizarre. PhD करके क्या तीर मार लोगे तुम लोग? Because you will have to come back to the world and convince the world that my research will change your life. And journal paper लिखने से कोई तीर नहीं मारता आजकल. So when you look at these issues, I very openly talk about to teachers that you are the beacons of change. अगर तुम collaborate नहीं करोगे, क्या change करोगे दुनिया को? And the world doesn't have time to read about your research. If you are expecting कि एक दिन लोग उठेंगे कि डॉक्टर गोदवानी का पेपर कहाँ है, नोबडी हैज टाइम. लोग उठेंगे कि कंगना रनौत क्या कर रही है, लेट्स सी दैट, दैट मे हैपन, बट तुम लोगों के एकेडमिक पेपर कोई नहीं पढ़ने वाला. ऑल राइट, सो देर इज अ वे द वर्ल्ड वर्क्स एंड यू शुड थिंक अबाउट दीज थिंग्स टू योर ओन लाइफ. ओके, एंड द लास्ट इज कॉम्पिटेंस, दैट ऑल ऑफ दिस कम्स डाउन टू योर एबिलिटी टू गेट समथिंग डन. दैट्स वेर यू हैव टू मेक डिसीजंस, यू हैव टू एग्जीक्यूट. And competence is that 6C. So this is what School of Meaningful Experiences focuses on. And this is built on a theory of charismatic leadership, which I'll spend few minutes more, and then we'll have Q&A and I'll take your questions. Charismatic leadership is a science which has been there for thousands of years. And I'll explain that. 2000 saal pehle, this is the Egyptian Greek civilizations that hum log bade history mein ratta marwate hain. This science was taught to kings. In fact, Aristotle had a book called Rhetoric, and he did not write that book. These were dialogues with Plato, uska guru, and Plato heard it from Socrates, uska guru, and it came down to Aristotle, and Aristotle documented that in 60 books, and Republic is one of them, Rhetoric is one of them. उस समय दिस साइंस वॉज टॉट टू किंग्स. वाई वुड इट बी टॉट टू किंग्स? बिकॉज द किंग हैड टू स्टैंड अप इन द सेंटर ऑफ द टाउन एंड स्पीक वाई यू शुड गिव मोर टैक्सेस. यू हैव टू कन्विंस पीपल. और वो जो आदमी सुन रहा है, द बिजनेस मैन, द यू नो भेड़े चलाने वाला, द ब्लैक स्मिथ, द कॉमन पीपल ऑन द स्ट्रीट, they will ask the king ki kyun dunga main aapko taxes, and the king would say ki bhaiya agar taxes doge to main tumko ek acha sa aqueduct banaunga taki tumhe acha pani milega, I will protect you from the barbarians who are about to attack, to paise do. So it was a same science which we today called persuasion or communication, but this is public speaking and this is oratory. Now, this is not only in the Greek and Egyptian civilization. Hamara Bharat 3000 saal pehle ye sab karta tha. In fact, the first documented evidence, and I believe in it, is the famous book called Gita. What is the Gita? There is a war. Arjun bolta hai, main ladai nahi karunga. And Krishna gives him a 45-minute speech, which changes Arjun, and suddenly he says, "Acha, main ladai karunga." This is communication and persuasion. And in our Vedic kalas, there were, I think there is a concept called 16 kalas, no, 16 vidyas and 64 kalas. I could be wrong, shayad 14. I could be wrong. Agar aap koi Google karke batayenge, to mujhe bada acha lagega. Kala and Vidya, I think the numbers are 14 and 64 or 16 and 64. Aap log check karke dekh. Ha, 16 Kala. Yes, 16 Kala. Dr. Deepanshu is right. 16 Kala and, no, I think Vidya and Kala. Aap Google karke dekh lijiye. Some Kala and Vidya. I think 64 is right. In one of the Kalas, the skills, one of them is called Samvachya, which is the art of conversations. And kings and noblemen were taught this art, because in those days, people from all over the world would come to your kingdom and talk to you. And you should be able to charm them with your words. In fact, Chanakya taught Chandragupta Maurya the art of conversations, because Chandragupta Maurya was a street-dwelling urchin. And Chandragupta Maurya was a street fighter, and Chanakya groomed him into a warrior to become a king. And to become a king, you don't need the sword, you need words, you need behavior, you need charisma. And this is very well documented in our Indian systems. In pe Sanskrit suktiyan likhi gayi hain. Kabir aur Rahim ke dohe are full of communication principles. There's a beautiful Rahim ka doha. Sorry, Kabir ka doha on criticism. The doha says, Nindak niyare rakhiye, aangan kuti chhavaye, bin sabun pani ke vastra nirmal hui jaye. Which means, keep your critics close to you. Their criticism will make you a better person. I mean, this is communication and charismatic thinking. So throughout our life, charismatic processes have been there. Now let's proceed from, yes.
Would you kindly repeat that sloka you just recited?
You can Google it. Google is very quick and accurate. I actually changed it according to my own stuff. It is called Nindak Niere Rakhiye Angan Kuti Chhavaye Bin Sabun Bin Pani Vastra Nirmal Hui Jaye. Just check the second part. I think I have modified it according to my own creativity. And that is Kabir Doha. K-A-B-I-R space D-O-H-A. एंड कबीर के और भी अच्छे दोहे हैं, रहीम के भी हैं, और आई कनेक्ट दीज थिंग्स एंड आई ऑल्सो ब्रिंग मूवीज ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स आर कनेक्टेड. सो लेट्स गो बैक सर,
कैन आई ऐड पॉइंट टू दिस वन सर?
यू कैन यस प्लीज गो अहेड.
यस सर, एक्चुअली इन तमिल वन इज कॉल्ड एज वन बुक इज कॉल्ड तिरुकुरल सर, व्हिच इज रिटन बाय तिरुवल्लुवर.
Yes,
where he says that a king should be surrounded by critics. Otherwise, what will happen is that he will get spoiled by courtiers. Yeah.
Absolutely.
So
he
will get spoiled, sir, definitely, if he is not criticized by the people surrounded by him, sir. That's one of the germs of Tirukural, sir. So thank you very much, sir.
Absolutely, you, sir. Dr. Karthikeyan. Tirukural is such a lovely book. And one of the English quotations I use is, a spoken word is like a bullet. It can create a lot of damage.
Yes, sir.
And it comes from Tirukural.
Yes, sir.
And very definitely nice. So we should, we should bring these things in our, there is a phone 9020, which is very noisy. So if you can chat with us, we can take your questions. So let's go to the Greek and Egyptian civilization. And come forward, that communication and charismatic leadership was the number one subject in those days. Aristotle and his philosophers would teach it. But now let's come to 21st century. This subject is gone. It's whitewashed. No school, no university will invest in it. And there are various reasons. There is no talent, there is no faculty, there is no research. Sab log English. Pardon my dig at British people. I un logon ne tabha kar diya hum logon, and we are still struggling with the problems of that system of Lord Macaulay. Actually, we should not even call him Lord Macaulay, and that's enough for him. And I am a very big patriot, and I feel very strongly that we are still not able to change this despite 70 years being independent. Anyway, let's forget my personal anger on this issue later. Let's come back to the question, ki ye subject kahan gayab ho gaya? And the answer is, the history has been very unkind to this subject due to a variety of reasons. By 400 after Christ, years after Christ, this subject became very important. In fact, a lot of people started to change public speaking, and politics became a big subject. And one of them was Cicero. And Cicero was openly killed by the kings because he would speak so powerfully that people started getting scared. Ki yaar, mere ko talwar chalana aata hai. Baat karna nahi aata. So the sword became more powerful. And people who could speak were killed. This is where another very interesting concept came. Religion became powerful. So this subject went into religious studies. In fact, charismatic leadership, even till now, the sources of research come from religion. Why would it happen like that? Because of a very simple phenomena. According to the definition of religion, religion was born when the most intelligent human being met the most stupid man. It's a very fascinating concept, right? Somebody said ki aap upar dekho and do something and aapki problem solve ho jayegi. And the most stupid man said okay, and he did that, एंड सम प्रॉब्लम ऑफ हिज लाइफ वेंट अवे. सो ही थॉट कि अरे यार आप जो बोल रहे हो ठीक ही होगा, यू मस्ट बी सुपर नेचुरल. एंड दिस पर्सन स्टार्टेड टू स्पीक एंड गिव सर्मन्स एंड स्टे रिचुअल्स कि आप ये पहनो आपकी सारी प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व हो जाएंगी. दिस बिकेम कैरिज्मेटिक लीडरशिप. एंड दिस पर्सन स्टार्टेड टू क्रिएट चर्चेज एंड टेम्पल्स कि आ जाओ आई विल सॉल्व योर प्रॉब्लम एंड गेव फियरी sermons and people would sing and dance in joy, praise the Lord. And we even know, even in 21st century, this is happening. There are many spiritual sects who use concepts of communication and charismatic leadership to attract people, and people do change. Now this word changes from persuasion and becomes a dangerous word that starts with M. Please chat with me. What is that word M I'm looking for? Come on, talk to me, chat with me. M. M word. M for Madhya Pradesh. Manipulation, Dr. Shivani Vashishth, very good. Manipulation. You can use this subject to manipulate people. Sadly, the entire world today is using concepts of charismatic leadership in a subject of business which starts with M and A. What is that M and A? Any business school professors, you should be able to crack this. Not merger and acquisition. Come on, M and A. Which subject uses this principle? Management, yes. Attituted, no. Assertion, no. Money and assets, no. कुछ भी आप लोग तो मतलब यू आर गोइंग ऑन अ इंग्लिश रोल राइट नाउ. आई लाइक इट. आई विल गिव यू द आंसर. द सब्जेक्ट्स आर मार्केटिंग एंड एडवर्टाइजिंग. व्हाट इज मार्केटिंग एंड एडवर्टाइजिंग? हियर इज अ एड. टेक दिस डिओड्रेंट, पुट इट ऑन योरसेल्फ, यू विल बिकम रिच. इट्स अनबिलीवेबल राइट. एंड पब्लिक बाय दैट डिओड्रेंट. इफ यू डोंट बिलीव मी, लुक एट द रिसर्च ऑफ मार्केटिंग एंड एडवर्टाइजिंग. What is advertising? A concept, a dream, a brand, but comes from communication. You are telling the world ki ye gaadi kharidoge, bahut successful ho jaoge aap. And in fact, there is this one of my most famous pastimes, jab main bahut stress ho jata hu, is to watch a television channel called Naap Tol. You should watch that. It is sheer genius. Usme, you know, there is this guy who says ki main bahut mota tha. And then I took some Baba ka powder, not Baba like Baba you are talking about, some powder, don't get, you know, I mean, and nowadays these things we have to be very careful. And I put that powder in water, garam kiya pani maine, lal color ka pani ho gaya, and I drank it, aur ab main John Abraham jaisa ho gaya. Unbelievable. Aur public kya khareedti hai us powder ko. And this is nothing but manipulation, communication. They create trust. How do they create trust? They bring a very big actor. And that actor says, ki main bhi jab peeta hoon to mujhe bada achha lagta hai. So people think, yaar, agar ye actor kar raha hoga, to theek hi kar raha hoga. Amitabh Bachchan to aajkal har jagah pahunch jata hai. Sorry, if anybody is Amitabh Bachchan's fan. But sometimes we should think about these questions. Abhi ek TV mein ad aaya tha, Cred karke company hai. Khatarnak company hai. Some billion dollar valuation. They roped in Rahul Dravid as a brand ambassador, right? And I'm a big fan of Rahul Dravid. Mera dil toot gaya us din ki yaar Rahul Dravid yahi karna tha tere ko. And so there are these are issues, but Rahul Dravid becomes the trust of that brand. And the moment he did that, the downloads of the app went up, people started using Cred more, and the company's valuations is now in tens of billions of dollars. These things work. My point is, all of us are being manipulated by somebody else without us knowing. Politics is completely built on charismatic leadership. If you look at all the charismatic leaders, politicians, they use their words and their behavior and that charm very well. So let's now understand how this subject has reached where it is. So somewhere in the 10th century, the wars of the world happened. The books of the world were burnt, and this subject lost to the sword, where might became right. Words were never introduced. That's why that era is called the Dark Ages. But somewhere in the 14th century, a miracle happened, actually 15th century. And that miracle was a person whose name was, let me quiz all of you. His last name starts with G, very famous name. The first name starts with J, a European who did something amazing. He invented something which changed the entire education world. Anyone? I'll give you a hint. It is something to do with printing. Think, think. And type your answers.
Johannes Gutenberg, who invented Very good. The printing machine.
Very good, Mr. Komal Mehrotra.
Yeah.
Very nice. Excellent. This person revolutionized the world. Not just him, many more, but he gets the credit. There was one more person, he's forgotten. What he did, he started to program the die and print many more books. Usse pehle, books were written by hand. So it was a very expensive business. To agar aapko padhai karni hai, you have to be a very rich person. That's why education till 15th century was highly aristocratic. Only kings would get it. But now this person started to print books. The same book could now be printed 300 copies in a day because of his printing press, and that too the typeset. Printing press was there. He created typeset. So from 15th century, the world started to get books. And the world started to read. And the world changed. And that's why the revolutions happened. The Renaissance period happened because of this. People started to talk. People started to feel ki yaar, ladai karne se kuch fayda nahi hone wala. Let's sit and make buildings, do business, create things, communicate, collaborate. And the world became better. Ships started to flow and they started to take books, and these books changed the world. And Arabic scholars, European scholars, Western scholars, Latin scholars, Indian scholars, Chinese scholars started to build universities. This was the time the world came back. And then another miracle happened. The king became more and more powerful and started to kill. So a lot of people on the street said, ki yaar ye gadbad hai. So they started printing pamphlets and started distributing to people. And the first such case is the French Revolution in the 17th century. But this printing of pamphlets is communication. They started telling the people on the street that the king is bad. They used to draw caricatures. And this gave birth to a business of communication, which we call today with a word called J. What is that word or subject in university that we teach in communication? Any guesses? J.
Journalism.
Journalism. Yes, very good. And mass communication. So two subjects. So this subject kind of went to journalism. So oratory was forgotten. Oratory became a very small area, and religious studies controlled it, and mass communication became print and all that stuff. And then the world wars happened, which is where communication changed again. That world wars wanted people to come and fight, so they started using advertisements and persuasion, and they started telling people that, hey, please come and fight for your country. There were ads created and people started to go. And today in 21st, this subject has become a department of management studies. Boss, if you want a job, you have to communicate. If you want to present, you have to pitch. And that's where this subject has been broken down into multiple departments. So some part is taken by management, some part is taken by mass communication, and some part remains with the linguistic department under social sciences and humanities. And that's why communication has become nobody's child. It's a foster child of everyone. It has lost its identity. And you all have a chance to make it come back again. Make a department, call it a communication department. All departments talk to me. Aapko strategy bhi communication ke saath hum padhayenge. Interdisciplinary thought. It needs research. It needs a lot more focus. It needs writing, cases, books. And I encourage all of you to start doing that. Please stop looking at Western research on this subject. India has its own problems. our students don't even know English. So don't take Dale Carnegie's book and teach them in classes. Don't take Carl Jung's research on introvert and tell people you're an introvert, because that's wrong. The context is very different. So all of you have a chance to rewrite history with communication and research, and that's the opportunity. And charismatic leadership, and I'll end my lecture in 5 minutes, give you some basic concepts, and then have Q&A. What is charismatic leadership? Charisma, by definition, is called a gift, God gift. But I don't think that's true. You can learn to be charismatic. There's plenty of evidence, and I'll give you one big data point of charisma. Did you all know the name of Barack Obama before 2004? Chances are no. So how did he become charismatic? So there are some six qualities that attract people, because charisma attracts people. But that is not enough. So there are six qualities that attract people. Let's understand that. Then there are certain behaviors that people observe to measure your charisma. And then there are some processes by which this leader will change you. So the theory is very simple. The theory comes from a theory called leadership. Right? What is leadership? You change people. That's all there is. So change and influence is the heart of leadership. And charisma is certain qualities of this person. All right? So now let me take you through these three theories, and then we will have Q&A. Theory number one, there are certain qualities of these people that you should start looking at, and we'll go through them one by one. Focus on the word attraction. There are certain leaders who attract us, and I'll give you six ideas how they attract you. We'll name them one by one. The first quality that attracts a leader, a follower towards the leader, starts with a word that starts with P. The word is P. And let's take the look of Barack Obama. What did Barack Obama have in 2008 that made him so charismatic, attractive? Everybody talked about him. Sorry? Patience. No, not patience. I have a lot of patience, personality.
Persuasion.
No, not persuasion, not
personality. So his style of communication, that opening thing he used to address the public. If you think you can, yes.
Yes, but that's not my answer. Think of one word starts with
personalization.
P.
Personalization.
Personalization. No, all of these are. I'm not saying they're not important, but they're not the answer I'm looking for. Ah, Ashish Dahiya, Ashish ji, Ashish Dahiya has cracked this. He says power, kursi. Are aap mujhe kursi pe buthao, hum bhi famous ban jayenge. And that's the first thing you should all focus on. Right? So Pradhan Mantri ji is famous because Pradhan Mantri is, it's a power. And I'm also very persuasive. My personality, I mean, look at my face. Not bad. But mere paas kursi nahi hai. Ye 1500 ki kursi hai, chalti nahi hai. I need to be a CEO. I need to be a great sounding position. So the first quality that attracts people is kursi. Tabhi to aap log dean ko itna respect karte ho. Wo dean jis din shift ho jayega, koi baat bhi nahi karega usse. Right? So the first quality of charismatic leaders is power. Okay, so write this down. Aapko kaam aayega. Second, what does Mota Bhai have ki you and I don't have? Word starts with M. Mota Bhai is Mr. Ambani.
Money.
Money, very good. Agar aapke paas paise hain, people talk about you all the time. Matlab, you are invited to sing a song also. Ki sir, aap gana bhi ga do, achha hi gaoge. And this is strange, right? Ki yaar, hum bhi ga sakte hain. Hame to koi bulata nahi hai. Par अंबानी जी और उनकी फैमिली को हर जगह में इनवाइट मिल जाता है. एंड दिस इज ट्रू कि भाई अगर आप रिच हो तो पीपल स्टार्ट गेटिंग अट्रैक्टेड टू यू. सो मनी इज अ वेरी बिग क्वालिटी दैट ऑल ऑफ यू शुड नॉट फॉरगेट. वो बात अलग है कि पैसा हाथ का मैल है. इफ यू थिंक लाइक दैट, मुझे दे दो. मुझे नहीं लगता कि पैसा हाथ का मैल है. पैसा इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड इट डज वंडर्स टू पीपल. सो दैट्स व्हाई वी आर सो फोकस्ड ऑन पावर एंड मनी. वी कवर टू. Now let's look at the third one. What does Albert Einstein have that you and I don't have? Mind. अरे निशान जी ने तो गाली दे दी कि सर आपके पास तो दिमाग ही नहीं है. आई लाइक इट. क्या कर रहे हो यार निशान जी, ऐसे तो गाली मत दो.
मेमोरी.
मेमोरी. आपने मेरे को फिर गाली दे दी कि मेरे पास मेमोरी नहीं है. इंटेलिजेंस. वेरी गुड सर. ये क्या मतलब, ये आशीष दहिया साहब, आपने क्या मुझे यहाँ पे इंसल्ट करने के लिए बुलाया क्या? अभी अब इंटेलिजेंस भी नहीं है, आईक्यू भी नहीं है. वेरी गुड. You guys, so sweet. Come on, give me a better answer. The answer starts with K.
Knowledge.
Now let me pause. This is very important for all of you to know. How do you measure knowledge? You can measure power, kursi, position, principal, vice principal, dean, chancellor, measurable. Money. 5 crore, 15 crore, you can measure. How do you measure knowledge? Chat your answers. Because this is my only request for all of you today. I can't help you with power. I can't help you with money. But I can help you with knowledge. How do you measure knowledge? Any answers? Experience, readings, thoughts? No, sir. Ability to communicate
by the feedback you receive.
Not feedback. No, not feedback. Evaluating. No. Communication. No. I'll give you the answer, and this is my request to all of you. By the way, there is one I think
by applying.
Yes, theek hai, apply kar sakte ho, but if you can't measure that with application, observation. I'll give you the answer. The word starts with P. P for Pondicherry. Jo aap log nahi karte ho.
Passion?
No. Arre, passion sabke paas hota hai, sir. Achar dalenge kya passion ka? Presentations? No. Not P. Come on. Uske bina aapki academic life chalegi nahi.
Publication.
Very good. Publishing. But please don't publish in journals that nobody reads. आप लोगों को टेन्योरशिप चाहिए. आई नो इट. ये सब बकवास है. जाके किताबें लिखो तो सो दैट चिल्ड्रन कैन रीड. और इफ यू लुक एट द किताबें, दे ऑल कम फ्रॉम पियर्सन एंड सम 4-5 फॉरेन कंपनीज. हमारे इंडियन ऑथर्स कोई पढ़ता ही नहीं है. एंड दैट्स व्हाई यू ऑल नीड टू राइट. सो प्लीज राइट इन न्यूज़पेपर्स, प्लीज राइट ब्लॉग्स, प्लीज राइट बुक्स एंड पब्लिश देम. And this is your service to our generation. ये आपका काम है. ये तनख्वाह लेके घर मत बैठो. अगर टीचर हो तो लिखो और लिख के पब्लिश करो. And that's why your focus of education becomes better. People will start following you. It's not easy. It's a very dangerous path. But please try it. और डेल कार्नेगी, और I remember हमारे communication में एक book है, Lessiger Rents. अरे यार उनको क्या पता हमारे इंडिया की प्रॉब्लम, और हम वो किताब छापे जा रहे हैं अपने करिकुलम में. सो आई थिंक देयर इज अ मशीन वी नीड टू क्वेश्चन. ये किताब 500 रुपए की क्यों खरीद रहा हूं मैं? द आंसर इज मनी गोज टू द पब्लिकेशन. इट डजंट हेल्प चेंज लाइव्स. सो इफ यू कैन राइट अ सिंपल बुक फॉर आवर चिल्ड्रन व्हिच कैन हेल्प देम अंडरस्टैंड कि यार आप बंगाली मीडियम से हो, हेयर आर 5 वेज टू स्पीक इन बेटर इंग्लिश, दैट्स अ गुड बुक. And research on it, and find out ways to help our children who come from these states, including your own. So the third thing is knowledge. There are 3 more qualities, and then we'll open up Q&A. The fourth thing, let me summarize the 3 and then go to the fourth one. The 3 qualities that charismatic leaders have are power, money, knowledge. There are 3 more. The fourth one, what does Lady Diana have? Brad Pitt, what do they have that you and I don't have? The words charm, beauty. I think Vibhuti has said it right. Beauty. Chandra also said it right. Very good. Beauty. This is where, please remember, beauty does not mean going to beauty parlor and, you know, all that. Beauty also means presence, the way you dress. You can be fat, black, whatever. But the way you present yourself is very important. And as a teacher, please look at what you wear. You should inspire your audiences with your presence. So this is the fourth one called beauty. It's very controversial, but the truth is it happens. We human beings are very judgmental. In fact, when we go to a sabzi mandi, we pick up the most beautiful looking vegetable. It's a very natural feeling. We never look at a tomato which had black spots on it. So don't feel bad about it. This is how we are. We pick a tomato which is very clean. And you have to now start thinking that when I'm going to my classes, when I'm doing an online class, how am I looking? What is my background? What do people think about me? Can I look in the mirror and feel comfortable with my clothes? Or am I too overdressed? Can I be consistent in my clothes? Because these things, the youngsters are looking at you. The fifth one is a word that starts with F. I think somebody had answered it. Rajat had answered it. F. What does Kangana Ranaut and Arnab Goswami have that you and I don't have? And I hope you never have that. F word. Rajat had cracked it. Rajat, speak up if you can.
Yes, sir. It's fame, sir. Fame.
Very good. Very nice. Fame. And all of you teachers, yeah, all of you teachers should become famous. Start your own channels. Have people follow you. Tab jaake wo padhenge. Varna kya? I mean, class mein ghuske lecture dene mein koi badi baat nahi. And I think that's a position that you're exploiting. So fame. And the last one, most difficult one, Gandhiji, Mother Teresa. What do they have that you and I don't have?
Humbleness, sir. Humbleness.
Sir, main bahut humble hoon. I am also very humble.
Simplicity.
Are, look at, sir, 200 rupay ki shirt hai. Very simple.
It's compassion.
I'm very compassionate. So are you.
Selflessness, sir.
Selflessness. I like that answer. Can you?
Empathetic. You should be empathetic to yourself. You should be empathetic.
Empathetic service. I'll give you another hint. Service. The word service is also a good answer. Another word starts with S, which has service and selflessness.
What is social responsibility? Social responsibility.
No. Social responsibility sounds like an MBA jargon. आजकल हमारे बच्चों को ये सब बोलने में बड़ा मजा आता है. Sir, I am very socially responsible. And now he go and buy a pizza sensitivity. Box. Sensitivity. No.
Survival skills.
No, there is an answer from Poonam. Poonam. Poonam, say it loudly. Poonam Kundu.
Sacrifice.
Very good. This is known as renunciation. Ki sab kuch hone ke baad, I will not take anything. And people are attracted to that. When a teacher sacrifices, Gandhiji sacrificed, Mother Teresa sacrificed. There is a reason why they are so high in leadership skills. But look at some of our modern leaders. They are also on the position. They take the maximum. Sabse bada ghar main hi banaunga. I think these are serious issues in leadership. And that's why the world doesn't like it. Ki, sir, ye galat hai. Aapne pehle to kaha ki aap ye sab karoge hamare liye. Ab aap bada sa ghar bana rahe ho. This doesn't sound right. I mean, people are not stupid. And that's what leaders sometimes ignore. Ki, aray, power hai to sab kuch chalega. That's not done. So charismatic leaders, while can have these qualities, the other two theories come in, that you need to behave like a leader. All right? And you need to communicate like a leader. Agar aapne ek bhashan diya hai ki main to aapka sevak hoon, par 3000 rupay ka ghar, 3000 crore ka ghar banaunga, something is not right. And these are requests I have for you. I'm not criticizing anyone. I'm saying audience is confused jaate hain. Ki, sir, I'm not able to understand. And that's the problem of communication. When a teacher says, you should be ethical, and in front of students does not pay the chai wala bill in the canteen because my teacher hoon, aur 5 rupay theek hai, adjust kar lenge. That is wrong. Aapke bachche dekh rahe hain aapko. And these are, to me, issues that you need to start focus on. So summary of my lecture, please adopt charismatic leadership principles to your own life. I'm not saying you become like, you know, become very well-dressed and well-coiffured kind of a person. I'm not saying you become Shashi Tharoor kind of a orator. I'm not saying any of that. I'm saying, first of all, reflect on your own leadership. Figure out what you can do to create your followers. And knowledge is a very good starting point. Please publish books which are relevant to our audiences. Second, please behave properly. A teacher has to be a guiding light for students. So behave like that. You are not supposed to vomit books in a classroom. You're supposed to inspire learning. And the last is, please communicate. Tell stories. Make them excited. Just say, aaj I tried my best. I hope I did. But this is the work I do. Ki, my focus is not to give you a 400 slide lecture. My focus is to inspire you and make you feel ki yaar maja aaya, this item number was good. Now I will go and study five books. That's what we should do. We should tell people that there are these five routes you take, but let's start that journey with the people. So on that note, I will stop yapping. All of you now can ask me questions. We have about 30 minutes or so. Any questions? I might have missed in the chat. So please go ahead. You can chat with me and
Sir, I have a question. My name is Dr. As you said, publishing of books, express the knowledge and wisdom. Is there anything regarding the publication of good research papers? As you all, we are in the university education system. So, publishing rather than the books on research paper is demanding. So, what's your opinion about it? What's you actually think? Because nowadays people are much more crazy about publishing in the research paper rather than the books. Because books takes a lot of time, near about to 1 year and, near about 2 years or so.
Your name is Patita Pavan.
Pavan.
Pavan, okay. Pavanji, my answer will shock you, so my apologies in advance. मेरे को लगता है हम academicians बहुत lazy हो गए. And you actually said that sentence कि books लिखने में बहुत time लगता है. But this is exactly what you should be doing. हम अपने बच्चों को बोलते हैं कि यार don't take the road less traveled. I mean don't take the road more traveled, something like that. Robert Frost की कविता. और हम खुद नहीं करते हैं. And this is my complaint with all academicians. सबको टेन्योरशिप चाहिए. क्यों चाहिए? अरे पैसा मिलता है, सेफ्टी एंड सिक्योरिटी फॉर लाइफ. और उसके लिए हमको 3 पेपर पब्लिश करने होते हैं. ठीक है, लेट्स फाइंड द मोस्ट इजीएस्ट राउट टू पब्लिश. इट्स नथिंग बट वो होता है ना, क्या कहते हैं, चेकलिस्ट बेस्ड थिंकिंग. कि मेरे को 3 पेपर पब्लिश करने थे, कर दिए सर, टेन्योर चाहिए मेरे को और उसके बाद इंक्रीमेंट भी चाहिए. व्हेन आई हियर दीज थिंग्स, इनफैक्ट one of the reasons I decided that I will never apply to any university is this, that when a professor says ki main sirf 3 credit padhaunga, because that's what is expected of me, 3 paper publish karunga aur 1 mahina kuch admin kar lunga, baki main apne office mein baitha hu, I'll figure out. This is wrong. Aapko professorship resign kar dena chahiye. You are not supposed to do this kind of work. There is problem in our country. I'll give you one more example. COVID-19 में list down the number of institutes who came forward and helped the situation. I think 10-15 से ज्यादा होंगे ही नहीं. और 900 institutes हैं हमारे country में. Everybody was doing tenure and research. I mean, one of the joke I have on many academicians is कि वो imagine करो कि अमिताभ बच्चन, शशि कपूर का एक movie है, दीवार नाम की एक movie है. कि मेरे पास बंगला है, बैंक बैलेंस है, तुम्हारे पास क्या है? एंड दैट सीन. सो इमेजिन यू एंड आई आर टॉकिंग कि COVID-19 में आप लोगों ने क्या किया. नाइदर यू वेंट टू द फ्रंट एंड एंड सपोर्टेड, नाइदर यू पब्लिश्ड एनी अर्थ शैटरिंग रिपोर्ट. व्हाट डिड यू डू? And this to me is more important. So I'm being a little bit melodramatic. Please don't get me wrong. But I want you to work hard. I want you to spend 6-7 years in one book. And Pabanji wo book reject bhi ho jayega.
Sir, sir.
And this is why you inspire your children. Ki yaar, I wrote a book in 20 years, 10 baar reject ho gaya. I can guarantee you, aapke students itna aapko yaad rakhenge. And one day they'll say ki, you changed my life, sir. You taught me how to fail. You taught me how to work hard. Aur ye shortcut wala publication, I mean, there was this one paper I was reading, kyunki mereko kisi committee mein bula liya tha. I looked at that paper and I asked this assistant professor ki aapne paper kyun likha. They said ki sir, mereko tenure chahiye, I don't care about this topic. Mereko koi zyada pyar nahi hai is topic se, wo to mere guide ne bola karna hai, kar diya. And I'm like, yaar, we have gone wrong. This is nothing but a wrong way of education. अगर यही करना था तो किसी बड़ी कंपनी में चले जाओ, वहां पे अच्छे पैसे भी मिलेंगे. यूनिवर्सिटी की सीट क्यों खराब कर रहे हो? सो हियर इज माय रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑल ऑफ यू, वर्क हार्डर. यू आर द बीकन्स ऑफ एजुकेशन. अगर आप लोग मेहनत नहीं करोगे, अगर आप लोग फेल नहीं होंगे, हमारे स्टूडेंट्स फेल नहीं होंगे. और अगर हमारे स्टूडेंट्स फेल नहीं होंगे, हमारे देश का कुछ नहीं हो सकता.
Sir, I wish Morning, to sir. Say something in connect to the query which he has raised. I would like to take it from your point itself, from leadership, citing 6 qualities the leader must have. And the third one, of course, was knowledge. I think, yes, if we are passionate, it is not essential that we have good publications as research papers. If we are passionate about our profession or educating, we can contribute. And I think an example right there with us is Mr. Rajbir Deswal, who is a prolific writer and has been the speaker, the distinguished speaker on day one yesterday. Despite being an IPS officer and the former ADGP of Haryana, sir has contributed to 20 books, and I think we as professors can seek inspiration from him. Rajbir Deswal, sir, are you here connected with us?
Yes, I'm very much connected,
sir. Sir,
I'm happy for Mr. Godwani, who rather underscored the need for publishing. And I just wanted to chip in, but you made me sudden, in fact, by mentioning my name and answering, you know, making me answer certain things. In fact, I want to make it clear to this forum, that this battery, that there is a very easy and affordable system nowadays to get published. It is not that you go to a publisher and he will ask you money and then he'll promise 10,000 copies. No, you can correct, you can collect your manuscripts and go for 100 copies even. You distribute your copies amongst your students and your, you know, friends and those. Somebody will take notice of it, definitely. And he is very rightly, Professor, as Mr. Godwani has very rightly said, you publish. Publishing means you communicate. Communication means you express yourself. When you express yourself, you are not tight-lipped anymore and you are not bottled up. So thank you very much for giving me this 1 minute, you know.
Thank you so much. Thank you, sir. I would also like to mention, sir, that here we have Chef Ritu Uday Kungaji. She, what Professor Godwani has cited, that we can contribute for columns in newspapers, in magazines, and that's what, as a chef, as a culinarian, Chef Ritu has been doing. Chef Ritu, are you there? Can you switch on your camera and share your experiences, please?
Dr. Ashish,
I hope I can see me.
She's there.
Sir,
yeah. Good afternoon to everybody. So what I did exactly, if you want to, you know, if I have to share my experience for the pandemic, was that I witnessed that people were just buying food ingredients out of panic and things like that, you know. So what I did is a little bit on my part was that awareness that we should not waste food, you know, just for the heck of, you know, panic, you know, storing your pantries with food and groceries will lead to wastage. So I started with zero waste recipes and then resourceful use of leftover food, how we can make new ingredients or new dishes out of it. So I started writing a few articles. I started giving recipes out to people. My blog is open to all. There is no charges at all. people can get in touch with me at any time of the day, 24/7, and I reply to their queries. This is not that I'm trying to, you know, tell that I am great. This is a bit of what I can do, you know, sharing my knowledge with people and gaining knowledge from them. So this is how we can, you know, at least we can minimize wastage. That's how I started doing things and writing a lot of articles. I do food blogging, food styling, and everything is open to the public so that they can learn from me. I can learn from them as well. Yes, Dr. Ashish.
Thank you, Chef Ritu. And I think that's what even Professor Godwani has shared with us, that life skills for blissful life is pursuing your passions, provided that they are with righteousness. And himself, he has shared his journey, that how he has faced different challenges. And at least, sir, I am a big fan of yours. I utilize your videos on SWAMP platform for a lot of my classes for communication in my university.
I would like to make a point here. You know, on, again, coming back to Mr. Godwani's suggestion on getting published, and you make a very humble beginning, you'll get noticed. I was pursuing my master's in English literature then at MD University. When I wrote a letter in the magazine called Surya in those days, edited by Menaka Gandhi, and my letter got adjudged the best, and I got a 5 rupees money order at my village and post office address. So that was something heartwarming and gladdening for me, and I began writing letters to editors. And that made me graduate into a middles writer or a writer of whatever merit, I don't really know. But yes, you have to make a beginning somewhere to get published. So that's my input. Thank you very much. Enjoy your...
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Back to Godwani, sir.
Yeah, so I'm very happy with more questions. I'm very keen to
hear. Can I have a question, sir? Can I have a question?
Yes,
sir?
Yes.
Thank you very much, sir, Professor Godwani, sir, for that insightful session. You have listed 6 characteristics, sir, for a charismatic leader, sir: power, money, knowledge, beauty, fame, and sacrifice. Will you please shed more light on beauty, sir? Because I still am not able to convince with that one word, sir, whether a leader, a charismatic leader, should have a beauty in him, sir, to be a successful leader, sir. Will you please shed more light on that, sir?
This is one of the most controversial elements, but there is plenty of research that comes from very simple. You could look at stereotyping, you could look at first impressions. You could look at how decisions are made in selection criteria of candidates. And there's plenty of evidence that looks color the decision-making slightly, right? Now, we are not getting into right and wrong. So when you understand this concept, avoid applying your own thought processes to this concept, because in India, we give very little importance to this concept, because in India, our culture says, do not focus on external beauty, focus on internal strength, which is absolutely gold sentence. But unfortunately, the reality of the world is not like that. The reality of the world is that when you do a study of candidates and start to see how this candidate will flare better, there is a study done by a professor of charismatic leader. I think his name is John Antonakis. They kind of shortlisted some candidates, took their photographs, and plotted their career trajectory over time. And they found that their looks played slight marginal difference in their success. They got better promotions. They were able to negotiate better salaries. And in many universities, including business schools, we talk about this. I very openly talk about it. And I call it presence. Presence is how you project yourself. And this is where there are 2 more concepts that we need to focus on. Presence is highly dependent on one's own self-confidence and self-esteem also. So many of us who feel that I'm not good enough compensate that by projecting better looks. That's also possible. Many of us who are very self-confident and very self-esteem say, why do I need to project my looks when I have knowledge and so many other things? So there is a balancing equation. And that comes from your personal choice. So break the question into two parts. What is your personal view on beauty? And what is the world's view on beauty? So my answer was on the world's view of beauty. And I gave an example that when we go to a vegetable market, our instinct is to pick the cleanest vegetable. That's how we decide. So when we are in an interview room and there are 20 candidates, we get biased by a candidate who's slightly different looking, better looking, as measured by my own interpretation of beauty. Sometimes we also do this in our own psychological effects. I'll give an example. We are in an international airport. Remember airports before COVID-19, they used to exist, they have gone. So there was international airport. We all would travel, and let's say there is a 6-hour flight gap. So we had to sit in a lounge. You should see how people judge where to sit. And this is, again, connections of who we are. So we are in an unknown place. We look at this big lounge of the whole world population sitting there. Our natural tendency is to find a table where we are comfortable. And chances are, you will gravitate towards someone who looks like you. Right? So we look at, oh, this guy looks like from India. Why? Because brown skin. Very dangerous sentence, racist comment actually. But our mind finds a very different way of using these things. So we sit that person. Now this person could be from America, but we stereotyped and judged them based on skin color. So our mind is very complex in this game. And sometimes it pulls back into, no, I don't believe in beauty. So that is one path. But the reality is that the beauty market and the way the world works is very, very critical. So your LinkedIn profile is very important. So look at your LinkedIn profile, look at the photograph. What are you conveying to the world? And many times we have photographs, which is like this, right? Whether we go to vehicle travel license, or we go to passport, or we apply for a job, same photo. And my request is that think about it. What are you trying to communicate? And if you stand slightly differently, look up and smile, you're now projecting to the world that I am confident. I know what I'm doing. Now, you could be a fraud, but only you know that. The world will get an answer that, okay, you are okay, confident. So sometimes this question goes from persuasion to manipulation. And this is where there is another concept called ethics, that use your own ethical judgment on what you think is the right thing to do. And you don't have to adopt any of these techniques. You can create your own. In fact, all of you watch this movie, which is a Malayalam movie. One of the best movies on communication comes from Kerala industry. It's called Trance, T-R-A-N-C-E. Absolutely brilliant movie. And it conveys the reality of religion, manipulation, oratory in a church. And there's a company that wants to defraud people by taking money and giving them insurance, and calling it that it's a church project. So they create a pastor who is trained in oratory and is given like training programs, and he become a amazingly successful human being. But his deep inside, he is conflicted that this is not my ethics. I should not fraud people. And then the movie becomes like that. So in that, he is groomed from a very simple Malayalam looking fellow. He looks like a pastor. So he dresses up like a pastor, suit, boot, he's shaved, he's, manicured and all that stuff. Because when you go on stage, people are observing you. And people make their judgments based on few seconds of interaction. That's why there's a quotation that first impressions matter. It's very difficult to change people after first impressions, but it's possible to change them, but it takes time. So that's the answer to your long answer to your question. So treat it with your own judgment, but know that it exists. You may not like it, but the world observes.
Definitely, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Dr. Nidhi. I would like to add to what you just said. Like, I'll share my experience. Like, we were, participating in the campus placements. I'm at FMS Delhi University. And, we were given all these classes on business communication. Professor Mala Sinha teaches us. And used to teach us, I mean. So there was a session on, dressing for the company interviews. So during this session, we were taught that we have to wear solids, solid shirts and, you know, trousers and lighter colors. So there was this gentleman, Sandeep Narayan, I still remember him. He wore orange color shirt for the interview. And, you know, the placement committee, they were busy convincing him to change his shirt. And the company on campus was Airtel, Airtel Bharti. And I'm a 2009 batch, so that was the recession batch also. So so this gentleman, he said, no, I will give the interview in orange shirt only. And trust me, he got selected just because of the confidence that he had. And his entire interview went on the color orange. There was no other topic that was asked by the HR. So I think it is also the confidence that we carry, which complements our beauty.
Absolutely. So, yeah, you're absolutely right. Lady Gaga is an example.
Yes.
So there are various theories that explain that. One is that you use this to stand out from the crowd. The second is you do it with a certain agenda in mind. And the college placement committees are very fixated. By the way, if you can convey this to the placement committee of FMS and all institutes,
sure,
I have two requests. I hope that the girls in that college are allowed to wear Indian clothes. This is one complaint I have.
Sir, at FMS, we were allowed.
Excellent, because I know many institutes.
We could wear saris and suits with dupattas. Suits with dupattas were allowed, not without dupattas.
Absolutely. And this is one fight I have lost in many institutes, because the students are very clear that, sir, don't play with our placement system. We want to maximize results rather than play with the system. So sometimes I feel that these clothes don't suit a certain body structure. And we Indians also have dark skin. So when I see a student wearing a dark suit, I ask him that, yaar, didn't you think of a lighter color? He's like, no, sir. Everybody wears dark, so I also wore dark. And this is what I hope all of us as teachers talk, that, hey, you are going in that room as a human being and as a future manager. You should think about these things. One day you will go in front of clients and they'll get they might make their decisions based on these little things that we sometimes ignore. Many Indian students find it very hard to come out of the colleges and go into the corporate world. And they question, why are we talking about dress code? I don't want to talk about it. And many of them get left behind just because the world is what it is. You can adapt or you can stay where you are.
Excuse me, sir. Can I ask a question?
Please.
Sir, I want to ask that if you said that sacrifice is also a key point in the charismatic leadership, but if we sacrifice something, aren't there some chances that we might get taken for granted by some people?
Yeah.
You can enlighten on this, sir.
Yeah. No, this is a common fear. So there is a concept in cognitive thinking called conditioning. Many of us are conditioned. So these questions come from there. So I'll give you an example. I work a lot with CEOs and managers, and I tell them, can you be more empathetic? And the first thing they say, sir, ye empathy factory mein nahi chalta. Because if I am nice to people, they will take advantage of me. So I'll tell you a very simple story that I heard from someone, which may or may not answer your question. It's a slightly 5-6 minute story, so bear with me. There was a general who was appointed as a general of an army, and the protocol of taking over as a general is that there is a big battalion which invites you. 8 o'clock in the morning, you come, you kind of come in a jeep, very well decked, and you take a salami of the soldiers. And then the protocol is the other general hands over the baton, you take the baton, sign some papers, and officially you are the general of the army. It's a very prestigious event. So this general, like that August ceremony, 8 o'clock in the morning, everybody's waiting for him, and he comes in this jeep. He's standing full sitare on his chest, and he comes, and all the soldiers are lined up and families are in the tambu, very pin drop silence kind of an event. And the general is about to become the general, right? So he comes, he takes a salami of the parade. So there's a red carpet. He's supposed to walk slowly and look at the soldiers who are on his left and do this for 5-6 minutes. It's a protocol. And all the soldiers are in Savdhan. This is the best day of their lives. They have to showcase the power of the battalion. So, theek hai saab, 8 baje general pahunch gaye, salami shuru ho gayi. And the general is walking towards this line of soldiers on the left and he stops. And he looks at one soldier and he sees a little bit of stubble. Thoda sa shave nahi kiya tha usne. So the general opens up his white gloves. Bilkul like a movie, opens up his white gloves and gives one tight slap to this guy. Then he puts the glove back again, continues walking and takes charge, and the whole battalion is talking only about this incident, right? And this poor fellow, iska duty khatam ho gaya, he's resting in his barracks. Shaam ke 4 baje, the general calls the attendant, ki jisko maine aaj thappad mara usko bulao, mere tambu mein. So the word spreads like wildfire, ki the general has called this poor fellow who was slapped in the morning. So everybody thought iska court martial hone wala hai. And this guy ran. Matlab, he thought ki aaj to gaya main, but within 2 minutes, he had to run. You know, it's an order from the top. Very disciplined kind of environment. So he runs to the tambu. And he's made to wait. The attendant says wait. And after 2-3 minutes, he's made to go inside. And he enters the tambu and he sees a very different scene. He sees that the general is in civilian clothes with some cravat and all that. White shirt and all that. And there's a very elegant tea is up front of him. So the general says, "Aao, baitho, baitho." And the guy sits very straight. And the general pours a cup of tea, gives 2 biscuits and gives it to this person. And you're not supposed to drink it. You're just supposed to keep it because general ke saamne pee nahi sakte. And the general sips. And he's asking, "Kahan se ho?" He says, "Sir, Bhatinda." And he's like, "Aapke ghar mein kaun kaun hai?" Ki sir, 2 bachche hain. Achha, theek hai. And he dips the chai and cookie and eats it. 2-3 minutes small talk. And the guy very nicely responds because he's waiting ki ab court martial abhi shuru ho jayega. And then the chai khatam, biscuit khatam, the general says, "Nice to meet you, jao, tata, bye bye." So the guy clicks his heels, salam saab, turns around, comes out of the tambu and says, "Boss, ye kya hua, meko to samajh nahi aaya kuch." Now you can't go back to the general and says, "Ki sir, ek question hai, ye aapne kya kiya, samajh nahi aaya, army mein ye sab nahi chalta." So the guy goes to his barracks and is very confused. And sab log pareshan kiya, ye to samajh nahi aaya. Anyway, chalo theek hai. And this incident was kind of forgotten. And kuch 10 saal beet gaye. The general has retired. He's become a very senior citizen. But he comes to the battalion to give some talks. Now this guy has become a colonel. To ek koi ceremony mein, this retired general is called to give a motivational talk. And this colonel is also there. Right? So if you were this colonel, you would wait for this opportunity. So event khatam ho gaya, chai wai ho gayi, khana wana chal raha hai. This colonel ambushed the general ki, "Sir, aapko yaad hai main kaun hu?" The general says ki, "Nahi, mere ko yaad nahi hai." He said, "Sir, remember your first day of the assignment and aapne kisi ko thappad mara tha?" The general says, "Haan, haan, I remember. Aap to Bhatinda se ho, 2 bachche hain, kaise hain aap log?" And the guy says, "Sir, you remember all that?" And the general says, "Yeah, I remember everything now. Now I am able to refresh. I remember I hit you and all that. How's your kid and how are your kids?" And this small talk happens for 1 minute. And the colonel says, "Sir, I can't take this any longer. I need you to tell me, us din kya hua? Why did you hit me? And then why did you call me and give me kya hai?" So the general says, "Ki, my dear fellow, this is management 1-on-1. Matlab basics of management. I was a new general. Us din main soch ke aaya tha ki I have to send a message to the battalion that I'm a tough guy. So I was walking. Tumhara chehra sabse achha laga mujhe. Worth hitting. To maine randomly tumhe select kar diya, ek thappad maar diya. Everybody got the message ki yaar ye bahut khadoos aadmi hai, aise dur raho. Message solved. Now I'm also a good human being. So I called you back. Because I want you to remember ki I may be a tough person, but I'm also a nice father, a human being, and you know, communication, conversation, all that shit." So this is the response to your question, that you have to manage this game. Leadership is a performance. आप नाटक कर रहे हो. ये जो हम लोग कॉलेज में आते हैं वो भी नाटक ही है. आई डोंट थिंक यू बिहेव लाइक दैट इन योर होम. अगर मैं मतलब मान लो जैसे क्लास में मैं आता हूँ रॉब के साथ, अगर वो रॉब मैं अपने घर में लेके आऊंगा ना, मुझे जूते पड़ेंगे. राइट? सो वी आर आई लुक एट इट एज अ एक्टिंग, दैट लीडरशिप इज अ परफॉर्मेंस. व्हेन आई एम ऑन स्टेज आई एम परफॉर्मिंग. व्हेन आई एम इन फ्रंट ऑफ माय पेरेंट्स आई एम परफॉर्मिंग एज अ सन. When I'm a father, I'm performing as a father. So I'll play with my child. I'll do. I'll talk to my child in a childlike manner, because that's communication. So when you become a manager, you have to act tough, but you also have to be nice. And you need to know when to play the game where. So if somebody is trying to take advantage, you should tell this person, ki boss, ye meri achhai ka fayda mat uthao. Laat marne mein bahut aage hoon. So you have to say these things, and there is a training program. When you are trained to be a manager, you have to manage these things. You can't be very friendly and very nasty at all times. You have to balance it. And this is where many managers don't like it. Ki sir, ye jig jig mere ko pasand nahi hai. And my response is ki agar tumhe jig jig pasand nahi hai, Himalaya chale jao. Himalaya mein koi nahi aayega aapse baat karne. Subah uthna, ek wo kabutar dikhega, kha lena usko. नदी बह रही है पानी पी लेना. लवली लाइफ, राइट? बट नन ऑफ अस वांट दैट लाइफ. हमको सबको शहरों में रहना है, मॉल जाना है, घर खरीदना है, गाड़ी लेनी है, पर जिग जिग नहीं करना. दैट्स नॉट पॉसिबल. सो यू ऑल हैव टू लर्न दीज टेक्निक्स. एंड देयर इज अ बुक आई रेकमेंड यू टू रीड. दैट बुक इज कॉल्ड लॉज ऑफ ह्यूमन नेचर. वेरी नाइस बुक रिटन बाय रॉबर्ट ग्रीन. You should study human beings. हम लोग मैथ पढ़ते हैं. अरे मैथ पढ़ के क्या तीर उखाड़ लिया यार हम लोगों ने. वॉल स्ट्रीट स्टिल कोलैप्सेस एवरी डे. स्टॉक मार्केट्स कोलैप एवरी डे. क्या इकोनॉमिक्स पढ़ के तीर मार लोगे आप लोग? स्टडी ह्यूमन बींग्स. स्टडी वॉट दे डू. आस्क योरसेल्फ कि यार ये आदमी इतना क्यों बिहेव कर रहा है. सो एक्साइटिंग. लेट स्टडी दैट. एंड देर इज अ मूवी, माई फेवरेट मूवी इज अ मूवी कॉल्ड आनंद, 1976. Rajesh Khanna, Amitabh Bachchan. What a delightful movie. That movie has only one message, ki mere paas finite time hai. Let me enjoy with people. Let me make friends. Let me learn from them. And that, my friend, is what you should do. Please learn to deal with your students, your colleagues. Sab log fayda uthayenge, because aap bhi fayda uthate ho. See, as a child, all children took fayda of their parents' love. मम्मी यू आर द प्रिटीएस्ट, मेरे को एप्पल आईफोन चाहिए. राइट? वी डू दैट. अब आप मैनेजर बन गए हो तो आपका भी इम्प्लॉय आएगा कि सर क्या हैंडसम लग रहे हो सर. ऑब्वियसली ही वॉन्ट समथिंग. सो लर्न टू डील विद दैट एंड बी वेरी केयरफुल. बी अ लिटिल बिट स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड, विच इज वेयर कैरिज्मेटिक लीडरशिप हैज मेनी थियोरीज. एंड वन ऑफ देम इज बी वेरी केयरफुल अबाउट योर बिहेवियर एंड बी कंसिस्टेंट. If you are a very tough person, you be a tough person throughout, no problem. If you're a very nice person, you be a very nice person throughout, no problem. But don't try and act in a wrong way. What I sometimes don't like is that teachers, professors, deans, directors, CEOs, they try and act very tough, but they are not. And the audience figures out, ki yaar ye natak kar raha hai. And I'll give you an example. One of your friends will call you, ki are Rakesh, I was remembering you, bahut din se baat nahi hua. That is natak. You know ki abhi ye kuch mangega. Right? So learn to deal with these things and adopt this as a part of your life. Kya, I have to deal with people. Mangega, de denge, theek hai. So there are various theories that come in that if you want to become influensive and influential, people should call you. And if they call you, you must do something for them. That's how politicians operate. And that's why they get the votes. It's a jig-jig job. Subah se shaam tak unka phone bajta rehta hai. They don't get time to go to Himalayas. And that's what they have decided ki yaar yehi hamara purpose hai, yehi hamara mission hai. And we'll do it. So please try and make it as a part of your life. And stop spending time on hard subjects. Spend more time in studying people, enjoying with them and managing them, because you love that topic.
Thank you very much, sir.
So we are at 1 o'clock, Ashish ji, and if there are no more questions, I'm happy to, I mean, everybody will be very hungry. Two ghante se bichare pareshan ho gaye honge mere ko sun sun ke.
Sir, it was a lovely and a lively session. We are so thankful to you. Before we bid bye-bye to the participants and express gratitude, it's time that I should invite Dr. Nidhi, who is Deputy Director with me at Center for Life Skills and Soft Skills. Dr. Nidhi, over to you.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Rakesh Godhwani, sir, I don't have enough words to thank and express my gratitude for this amazing lecture. It was so enriching and I have really learned a lot. Though I have been teaching business communication to MBA graduates, but I feel that it's just, I'm at a very nascent stage of learning. I don't know how am I teaching. So it was a very interesting lecture, starting from the 6 C's that you told us and how we as teachers are beacons of change. And it's also something in common that we share. I also always discuss Krishna in my classrooms as a communicator, as a strategist, as a philosopher. I mean, he has a tremendous role to play in even almost every aspect of business management. So we have a lot to learn from our own, you know, Vedas. And how, you know, you also discussed that how Chanakya taught Chandragupta, you know, how to be a better king, and the role that we as teachers can play as change makers. So, sir, I really I thank you for your sparing your valuable time for this session. But trust me, it is just the beginning. We will keep troubling you every now and then. And I express my thanks from my end and the entire team of participants. I'm also a participant in this event. So it is, I think, one of the best lectures we have had till date. I'm very thankful to you. It was very interactive. And hope to see you, sir, again. And I shall stay in touch because I'm related to communication. So I would, you know, really want to be a part of the school that you are, you know.
Thank you, Dr. Nidhi. I just want to apprise Rakesh Godhwani, sir. Sir, your words means a lot to us. The book which you have shared from the center, we have provided e-copy of the book to all the participants.
Oh, wow.
Of the Connect.
Thank you.
So that has been provided to them, sir. And I'll request all the participants to switch on their cameras so that we can have a virtual photograph ceremony with Rakesh Godhwani, sir. So humble request to all participants to please switch on their cameras to have a photograph. The same will be posted in your groups immediately.
Please send me a copy as well. I love
certainly,
to show
sir.
Off.
Certainly, sir. Certainly, sir. Waiting, waiting, waiting for all smiling faces. All smiling faces.
Sab photo khichane aate hain. Lecture ke time mein I was asking nobody switch off.
I have taken one and...
We wish to see you speaking, sir. And that was a thrill, in fact.
Thank you very much. You're very kind, all of you.
Sir, here I wish to apprise you that we purposely keep the cameras off for the reason that at times bandwidth turns out to be an issue. Yeah. And nobody wished to miss any point or session of yours. So that was the reason probably that the participants didn't turn on their cameras. But then yes, believe me, we really had a session that was eye-opener. And the insights you have given to us for communication indeed helps us to go for a blissful life. Thank you. Thank you so very much, sir. Our gratitude.
Thank you. Thank you, Ashishi. Have a nice day, everyone. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much, sir.
So, thank ladies and gentlemen, sir. It was amazing to have Mr. Rakesh Godhwani ji with us, luminary. And believe me, I've been really following him from past 1 year. His sessions have been amazing and mesmerizing.